So there's a huge opportunity here to mobilize these people bottoms up. But no change is going to come unless it's bottoms up. If you go look at the history of change, nothing has ever happened top down. Nothing. It's always been through bottoms up movement. So my running for president is actually about mobilizing a bottoms up movement. So, you know, in about 10 minutes, I'll be getting on another call with people from all over the world. We have now leaders we're mobilizing worldwide. All of you should get involved in the movement for truth, freedom, health. And we have now leaders. So nearly 500,000 people have mobilized. And from them, using meritocracy, we didn't do a top-down system. We're finding who really learns the material, who's a local leader, and then we're appointing leaders, and then they get to go locally. But nothing's going to happen without freedom. Once you destroy freedom, there's no more innovation. And the innovation you get has nothing to do with freedom. You know, the Chinese model of innovation, it's a centralized model. It may lead to something, but it's not going to lead to the kind of innovation that is the possibilities that we don't even know what it means to be a human being anymore once you constrain freedom.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Shiva, yep, for your inspiring answers and also inspiring presentations. So I pass back to Professor Richard.
Okay. Thank you, Pak Kun. Pak Yusuf, silakan, Pak Yusuf. Pak Yusuf.
Okay. Saya okay. Thank you, ya, Pak Richard. Yeah. Dr. Shiva, we do hope that you will progress in the next presidential election in the U.S. You are neither a Republic or a Democrat, right? Right. So
yes,
please tell me how you manage your endeavor in this case. Do you just put your hope only on the belief that American people have been changed from party power to individual character power? Or is there any other aspect that you can share with us, please? Thank you.
Yeah, so first of all, let's, if you think about, like, if you just take the state I'm in, out of the 4.5 million people registered to vote, only 10% are Republicans. 35% are Democrats. The other 55% don't associate with any party, okay? So most people don't even associate with any party. They've already realized this system is rigged. And again, as I mentioned earlier to Dr. Kun, you know, there's another 50% of people don't even vote, okay? So if you look at the actual numbers, people don't believe in the existing system. So what happens every 2 to 4 years is that those in power have to entertain people to get them back involved. So they create this fake division. So they have Trump and then he gets indicted and then they go impeach Biden, right? It's all just theater. It's pure theater. And now with social media, people have data to understand where people are going. They know, wow, a lot of people are breaking from the left and the right. They don't want to be part of this institutionalized system. So that is why in this current election, they have created people who literally will steal our content and plagiarize it, because we're the real deal bottoms up. And what we have noticed is our strategy is to not only expose the obvious establishment, but the not so obvious establishment. One of the things we teach in politics since the 1950s, and this has occurred globally, that in the old days, if you were for real change, they would destroy you, right, with the hammer, you know, just obliterate you with fascism. But now what they've done is they've created fake heroes and false idols who are people who are actually part of the establishment, but they would say things that make you think, oh, he's against the establishment. But they ultimately bring people back into the establishment. So in the United States, it's people like Kennedy and Trump, Bernie Sanders. So we actually not only do this, first of all, we explain to people this dynamic That's the key thing. Getting back to what I said, it's about education. Once people understand this manipulation dynamic that's taking place, they're not going to be caught into the Maya, the illusion of this divide. The divide is actually fake.